Welcome back to Watch It Played. My name is still Rodney Smith. Turns out my application to have my name changed was rejected. I guess the government has more rules than even this game. Well, let's move on. The first thing we're going to want to do, as Hamster Bake pointed out, is give this encounter card deck a shuffle. Although the quest card doesn't say it, it allows us to draw a card from the encounter deck, and it makes sense that we should have to shuffle the encounter deck after doing that. So thanks for pointing that out, Hamster Bake. There we go, nice quick shuffle. That should do it, and now we can begin. Now at the end of our last video, we had just finished up the combat phase, and so now we're on the refresh phase. And we'll increase our threat by one. And now we can begin the next turn. As usual, we'll collect our three resource tokens, and then we're gonna draw a card. Now what will it be? I predict, if I just, you know, was gonna guess something, I would guess Blade of Gondolin. Incredible, incredible. That, you know, guys, that's just years of gaming experience at work there. So because we don't need progress tokens anymore, the Blade of Gondolin is a little less attractive. I think instead I'll bring out the Veteran Axe Hand and the Horn of Gondor. So we'll place the Veteran Axe Hand up here, and then we've got to figure out who to attach the Horn of Gondor to. I mean, it doesn't really matter too much, so I'm going to place it to Legolas. If things go well, this really should be our last turn. And I suppose that could be a big if. While questing for progress tokens is not as crucial at this point, we still need to think about questing to prevent our threat level from increasing. Like right now, if we didn't commit anyone to the quest, we'd have zero willpower going up against at least three threat strength. Remember, we're going to be adding another card to the staging area, so potentially more. And so that total threat strength would then be uncountered, meaning that the entire threat strength would be how much our threat level would increase by. At the same time, I need to leave enough attackers available because I want to defeat the Ungolian spawn this turn. So with that in mind, I'm going to commit Phelan to the quest, which only gives us one willpower strength to commit to the quest, but we do get to use his ability. So let's reveal the encounter card here. It is the Chieftain Uftak. Given his engagement cost of 35, we know for sure he's going to be engaging us this turn, so that's something else we have to consider. But first of all, let's put this damage token on the Chieftain, thanks to Thalen's card effect, and now we'll resolve the quest. So the total threat strength in the staging area is 5. It's being countered by Thalen's willpower of 1, which means our threat level is going to go up by the difference of 4. And with no location cards in the staging area, we can skip past the travel phase and move right on to the encounter phase. We're not going to have a choice here. Both of these enemies in the staging area have an engagement cost less than our threat level, so they're both going to engage us. So we can deal them both a shadow card, like so, and now we have to resolve some combat. So of course we have to block with our ever-returning Gondorian zombie spearman, and he is going to get to use his card effect to immediately damage the Ungolian spawn for 1. Now we'll resolve the shadow card, which is easy to do because there's no shadow card icon there, so we'll just discard it and resolve the attack. An attack of 5 strength against a defense of 1. Once again, our zombie returns to the grave. Will he rise again? I doubt it. So he's dead, but don't forget we have the horn. So once a character leaves play, we get to add 1 resource to the attached hero's pool. So Legolas just got 1 resource token. Okay, so now we have to resolve the Chieftain's attack. I'm going to declare a defender, and I'm going to use the veteran... Yes, I'm going to use the Veteran Axe Hand to defend. So now I'm going to flip over the shadow effect card. Okay, we weren't as lucky this time. There's a shadow effect. It says, shadow, defending player must choose and exhaust 1 character he controls. Ah, 2 characters instead if this attack is undefended. Okay, well, okay, this is bad. This really messes with my strategy. See, my plan was going to be to block the Chieftain and still have these 3 characters to attack next turn, whose total attack strength would have been 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, which against the Ungolian spawn defense of 2 would have meant we would have placed 8 damage tokens on the spawn and won the game. But now I have to exhaust another character, and so I'm going to exhaust the horseback archer. And then we can resolve this attack. So the Chieftain has an attack strength of 3, our defense is 1, that's going to be 2 damage, which is enough to kill the Veteran Axe Hand. So he's going to go to the discard pile, but we lost another character, so we get to claim another resource token for Legolas. And here's something else we have to consider. Look at the forced effect on the chieftain's card. It says, after a chieftain of fact attacks, place one resource token on him. The reason we do that is because the chieftain gets +2 attack strength for each resource token on him. So every turn he stays in play and gets to attack, he's going to get stronger and stronger and stronger. Now this really messes up my strategy, because I was planning on putting the total attack strength of these two characters against the spawn. They would have at least been able to place 6 damage tokens on the spawn, nearly killing him, you know, and so then next turn we'd definitely be able to get rid of him. But if I don't get rid of this chieftain, I'm going to have 2 very powerful attacking enemies that I'm going to have to block, or they're going to kill at least one of my heroes, and depending on what kind of shadow cards they get, maybe more. So I think I'm going to have to put my attack strength against the chieftain here. I don't know, I've debated it back and forth. I think that's what I've got to do. So I'm going to commit these two to attack. So we got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, total of 8 against a defense of 3. So 5 damage is going to be enough to kill it, because we already have 1 damage token on the chieftain. He's going to go away. Now, I'll show you something else on his card. In the text in the bottom here, it says victory 4. So when you defeat a card, or you complete a card that has a victory number on it, you keep that card, you put it to the side. So I'm going to do that right now, and we'll talk about that more at the end of the game. So that ends the combat phase. We can discard this shadow effect card, and now we can refresh. That didn't quite go the way I expected, but what are you going to do? Let's hope we have a little more luck in the next turn. And look at our threat level. We're all the way up to 40 now. Oh, and before we move on to the resource phase, I also have to ready our ally. Sorry about that, horseback archer. Okay, so now we can collect our 3 resource tokens. 1, 2, and 3, and draw a card. Okay, and it's the Citadel Plate. We've seen this card before. And now in our planning phase, because we actually were able to collect those 2 extra resource tokens because of the horn, we're going to be able to afford bringing out both of these items, which is good. So I'm going to do this right now. I'm going to pay for the armor for sure and attach that to Gimli. I'm doing that because if Gimli gets damaged, it will boost his attack strength, so I want to give him the opportunity to get boosted as much as possible before dying. And so then the Blade of Gondolin I will place. Why not place that on Gimli as well? So now it's the questing phase, but I don't think I'm going to commit anyone to the quest. Now, as long as I don't pull a treachery card, I'm hoping I'll be okay, because if I get an enemy out, then hopefully I'll have enough characters still ready to block 2 different attacking enemies and still be able to attack that Ungoliant spawn. But we'll have to see. So let's just get this over with. I'm going to add 1 card to the staging area, of course. I didn't get a treachery, but I got a pretty bad enemy here. I got the Hummerhorns. You might remember this from previous episode. He has a forced effect where if he engages you, he deals 5 damage to a single hero you control. All right, let's resolve the quest part. He's got a threat strength of 1, so our threat level is going to go up by 1 because we didn't have any willpower strength to counter that. So now in the travel phase, we do nothing because there's no locations to travel to in the staging area. So we move on to the encounter phase, and because our threat level is so high, this enemy is going to engage us. And with its forced effect, it's going to deal 5 damage to a single hero you control. Now, believe it or not, this is actually a really good thing. Because we were able to put the armor on Gimli, and that was only because we were able to get the horn out in time to collect resource tokens, this is going to allow us to pump Gimli's attack strength way up. Because we'll place those 5 damage tokens on Gimli. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And thankfully he's got 9 total hit points because of the armor. So we've actually just added 8 to his initial 2 attack strength, which means he can attack for 10. So with that in mind, let's begin by dealing our shadow cards out to our enemies. And then we have to pick which one we want to resolve the attack from first. I'm thinking let's declare a defender against the Ungoliant spawn. We'll put our horseback archer in the way, and now we'll resolve this combat. There's a shadow effect here. It says, defending player must choose and discard 1 attachment he controls. All right, this isn't terribly bad. I do have a few attachments to choose from. I think I'll just remove the Blade of Gondolin here. It's a little less important at this point. So I'll put that in the discard pile. And now I will resolve the attack. So we've got an attack strength of 5 going against a defensive 1. That's definitely going to remove the archer from play. But we do get to collect the resource token because Legolas has the Horn of Gondor. So now we can remove this shadow card from play and decide who, if anybody, is going to block the Hummerhorns. I think it makes sense to block with Thalen. I don't want to leave it undefended because I don't want another one of these wacky shadow effects that's going to disrupt my strategy. And Thalen, he still has a few hit points. He has a pretty decent defense. So let's commit him as a defender and then reveal the shadow card. Okay, good. There's no shadow effect icon here. The Hummerhorns does an attack of 2, and Thalen has a defense of 2, so no damage is going to come through from this attack. And now, it is time for Gimli to raise his mighty axe and slay the Ungoliant spawn. With a little bit of help from Legolas, so we will commit both of them to this attack. And that means we have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 attack strength against the Ungoliant spawn's defense of 2. So we will do 11 damage to the Ungoliant spawn and defeat it. Finally, in this last turn, the dwarves rise up and show their ability in battle. And as the quest card showed, once we defeat the Ungoliant spawn, we win the game. So, well done everybody. Thank you for your help, because I certainly couldn't have done it without you. I certainly would have made more mistakes without you, that's for sure. But we're not done yet. There's a couple of things we want to address before we move on. Now, although we've completed the quest, we can actually score our performance. And that's why I had you set aside this card with victory points on it. In order to determine your final score, you need to look at 4 things. Your final threat level, the threat penalty on all dead heroes, and the number of damage tokens on all surviving heroes. And you take that total and subtract any victory points that you've collected. With this kind of scoring, you're looking to have as low a score as possible, which could, if you're really successful, result in a negative score. In fact, you can go right onto the Fantasy Flight Games website and log your quest results right there. So let's tally this up. We start with our threat level of 41. We have no dead heroes. We do have a total damage of 11, which brings our total to 52. And we get to subtract our victory points here from the Chieftain. And that leaves us with a final score of 48. Now, is that a good score? I honestly don't know. I've never scored a game before. In fact, I don't think I've ever won a game with a tactics deck before. So 48 sounds pretty good to me. So that ends our game. But I hope you stick around. I'm going to do one more video, just a discussion video, to answer some people's questions that they had about things that maybe didn't come up in the game. And also, I want to shamelessly beg you for your support once again. So I hope you come back for that. And don't forget, we're going to be doing a playthrough of Small World next. I hope you return for that as well. And thanks again for watching. Thanks for all your feedback and your support. You made it really fun for me. I hope you enjoyed it too.